और बड़ी खबर इस वक्त ये आ रही है कि जीएसटी काउंसिल की बैठक चल रही है गोवा के पैनजिम में, जहां पर वित्त मंत्री निर्मला सीतारमन इस वक्त एक प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस को संबोधित कर रही हैं। वित्त मंत्रालय ने कुछ छूटों का ऐलान किया है, वो भी आपको बताएंगे कहां कहां राहत मिली है जीएसटी में, ये भी एक और 11 में शामिल होगा।
कॉर्पोरेट टैक्स में कटौती का फैसला किया गया है, घरेलू कंपनी और उत्पादन पर टैक्स घटाने का फैसला हुआ है।
We want to have more investments and make in India, which itself means a lot more investment, lot more employment generation, lot more economic activity, as a result of which economy will give us more revenue. So this is not just a debate in terms of, oh my God, you've got this problem, your revenue collection, and therefore would you not want, don't do it or do it, it's not the option. In order to strengthen Make in India, obviously.
Ma'am, the markets are definitely cheering the move today. Immediately, we've seen the markets positively reacting to the developments today. I want to ask you the fact that you've said that, you know, there's going to be a positive impact on the economy as well. But what about the fiscal targets that the government has set out of 3.3% for this year as well? And also, with this move, we've come almost in line with the other Asian peers as well. So how do you, you know, look to compete in which sectors are we looking at competing now in terms of manufacturing?
First of all, and that's the reason why you wanted to join TIMC on that first question, the idea is economic buoyancy will itself generate enough reasons for better income revenue generation. One. Second, the moment the taxes are brought down, you're also expected to widen the basket. So that is another reason why I think we will definitely be having a positive impact on the revenue collection. Yes, you're right in saying now we are almost at par with many of the Asian and Southeast Asian countries in terms of the corporate rate taxes. So as a result, when you're looking at the comparative rates, today we are probably one of the lowest and at par with the lowest in Southeast Asian countries. So I would like to again sort of remind, the rate at which we are now going to tax is 22%, and then for the old established companies, for the newer investments which are coming, 15% is what the slab is, the rate is. And therefore, when you calculate and other things, added surcharge and all that, you have different decimal points also getting added. But it is 22 and 15. 22 for existing and 15 for those who are coming in who will manufacture before 23. So that itself, 22 and 15 are the two numbers which I would like to drive home. 22 and 15 are going to now draw more new investments because of the 15 and make people who want to expand on the existing investment, existing businesses, 22 should stand out. And that would be comparable with the lowest rates in this region and in Southeast Asia.
Good morning, ma'am. This is Girish from Mint. My question is, what are the conditions for availing the 22% corporate tax?
Do you want to explain?
Yes. Actually, only condition is that they should not be claiming any other exemptions. For example, today, what kind of exemptions and deductions we give? For example, an unit is located in SEZ, or you know, somebody is getting an accelerated depreciation. Somebody is spending in the R&D and some other fund. So in such cases, the companies who are